यहाँ पर हम देखते हैं बाकी के जो क्वेश्चन है, इलेक्ट्रिकल पावर जनरेशन एंड इकोनॉमिक कंसीडरेशन के जो क्वेश्चन है, जैसे कि एज द साइज ऑफ थर्मल पावर यूनिट इंक्रीज द कैपिटल कॉस्ट पर किलोवाट ऑफ इंस्टॉल कैपेसिटी इज दैट इज डिक्रीज। कैपिटल कॉस्ट पर किलोवाट ऑफ इंस्टॉल कैपेसिटी डिक्रीज इफ द साइज ऑफ द थर्मल पावर प्लांट इंक्रीज। The modern trends in electrical power generation to have large size thermal power plant located near coal field. Next, in feed water and steam circuit of thermal power plant, the condensed flow from the condensed extraction pump to the boiler feed pump and then to the boiler. The HP and LP heater are located in the circuit in relation to boiler feed pump, that is LP heater before the HP heater after BFP. In thermal power plant, the pressure is working fluid cycle is developed by feed water pump. De-aerative heating is done to remove the dissolved gases in water. In thermal power plant, feed water coming to the economizer is heating using the flue gases. Arrange the following in order the sequence in which the flue gas passes through them after coming out the boiler in thermal power plant, that is first is economizer, second is air preheater, and third is electrostatic precipitator, and fourth is ID fan. In bleeder turbine, the part of steam is extracted for that is Badcock and Wilcox. Water is supplied to the boiler at more than the steam pressure in boiler. The efficiency of boiler used in the modern steam power plant, that is 85%. The steam pressure used in steam power plant in India in range of 110 to 170 kg per centimeter square. Next हम देखें the function of economizer is heat up the incoming water from the extant gases and steam in superheated in order to improve the rank line cycle efficiency, reduce the initial condensation losses, avoid too high temperature in last stage of the turbine. Superheated steam is always at the pressure lower than the maximum cycle pressure. Which of the following enter the superheater, that is wet steam? Within the boiler, the steam has highest temperature in superheater. In a superheater, the temperature rises and pressure remain unchanged. The selection of the type and size of the steam boiler depend upon the power required and working pressure. For giving power, a water tube boiler occupies less than floor area and more height. Pipe carrying steam are generally of steel. The boiler using lignite as a fuel. Don't use underfeed stroker. Which of the following steam will have the least enthalpy, that is bed steam at 25 kg per centimeter square? In a boiler, they carry over the slugs of water into a piping because the dirty water is called the foaming. A supercritical boiler is one that operates above the pressure and temperature is following value, that is 280 kg per centimeter square and 40 degrees Celsius. Critical pressure for steam is the range of 200 to 250 kg per centimeter square. Next हम देखें in regenerative surface condenser. There is two pump to remove the air and condensate. There is two pump to remove the air and condensate. In a surface condenser, on removal of air, absolute pressure of condenser is reduced. The purpose of boiler feed pump is to pump water into the boiler. The function of air pump in a condenser is to air linking into the condenser and maintain vacuum. Wet air pressure is to remove the both air and condensate. In a steam power plant, cooling tower are used for cooling condenser outlet water. Spray ponds are used for cooling warm water coming out the condenser is small power plant. In small power plant. The drawback of spray pond is first is large ground area is required, especially in case of large size power plant. Loss of the water due to the evaporation and considerable quantity of water is carried away in air when it is velocity is high. In which of the following steam power turbine the back pressure will be below the atmospheric one, that is condensing turbine. The modern steam turbine are impulse reaction turbine. In case of reaction steam turbine, there is a enthalpy drop both in fixed and moving blades. Next term dekhe. In shell and tube surface condenser, in shell and tube surface condenser, there is cooling water through the tube and steam surrounding them. In the shell and tube surface condenser, cooling water passes through the tube. Cooling water passes through the tube and steam surrounding them. And steam surrounding them. In jet type condenser, steam and cooling water mix. Evaporative type of the condenser has steam in pipe surrounding by water. The function of condenser in steam power plant is to condense the large volume of steam to water to be used as a boiler feed water, receive the large volume of steam exhausted from the steam turbine, and maintain the pressure below atmospheric so that the maximum heat energy can be extracted from the steam. In which part of the thermal power plant the steam pressure is less than that of atmospheric, that is condenser. Increase in condenser back pressure will lead to gain. In steam turbine circle, the lowest pressure occur in condenser. In a steam power plant, water is used for cooling purpose in condenser. A condenser in a steam power plant condenses steam coming out of a turbine. Condenser in thermal power plant are the condensing steam to water. A preheater in steam power plant recover the heat from the flue gases leaving the economizer and improve the combustion rate and raises the temperature of furnace gases. The advantage of reheating of steam in a turbine is that in increase the efficiency of turbine, reduce the wear on blade and increase the work done through the turbine. Economizer in steam power plant improve the boiler efficiency by 10-12%, saves fuel consumption by 5-15%, and become a necessary for pressure exceeding 7 kg per centimeter square. In steam power plant, heat from the flue gas is recovered in economizer and air preheater. Next term dekhte hain, the largest यहाँ पर The largest size of steam turbine installed in India, that is 500 megawatt, as compared to steam at entry to the turbine, which of the following will be larger at exist, that is specific volume? For the same power, the size of turbine decreases with speed. The pressure on the two blades of the impulse wheel of a steam turbine is the same. Preheat factor in steam turbine depend on stage efficiency, exit pressure, and initial pressure and temperature. In steam turbine, the reheat factor increase with increase in number of stage. The value of reheat factor for the multi-stage steam turbine lies in the range of 1.01 to 1.06. Steam turbine are governed by throttle governing, bypass governing, and nozzle control governing. Topping turbine are high pressure non-condensing one. The compounding of steam turbine is done in order to reduce the rotor speed. The governing employed for the medium and large size steam turbine is a nozzle. The ratio of exist pressure to inlet pressure of maximum mass flow rate per unit area of steam through a nozzle when the steam is initially superheated is 0.5457. The ratio of exist pressure to inlet pressure of maximum mass flow rate per unit area of steam through the nozzle when the steam is initially dry saturated is 0.578. The effect of considering friction in steam nozzle for the same pressure ratio lead to increase in dryness friction of the exist steam and decrease in exist velocity from the nozzle. Next time देखते हैं. The coal that has highest ash content is lignite. The average ash content in India coal is around 20%. The coal rank classified coal as per its degree of metamorphism. Coal is usually considered of vegetable origin. Low grade coal have the low calorific value. Which of the following is considered to be superior quality of coal, that is bitumens? Coking cokes from lumps and masses of cokes. Coal used in thermal power plant is also known as steam coal. The coal having highest calorific value, that is anthracite. The coal of lowest calorific value, that is lignite. Calorific value of coal largely depend upon ash content. Heating value of coal is roughly 5000 to 6500 kcal, yani kilo calorie per kg. A 200 megawatt steam power plant will consume nearly 2000 tons of coal per day. Any leakage of air into condenser destroy the vacuum and fuses as increase in air pressure in the condenser limiting the useful heat drop in the steam turbine, lowering the partial pressure of the steam and the saturation temperature along with it, and undercooling of the condensate more severe. The steam is superheated to the highest economical temperature in order to reduce the requirement of steam for given output of the energy owing to its high internal energy and thus reduce the turbine size. Next हम देखते हैं. Belt conveyor can be employed for transporting coil in inclination up to that is 30%. The maximum length of screw conveyor is around 85 to 90%. The small power plant coal is unloaded by means of coal accelerator. The large load carrying capacity of belt conveyor is around 550 to 100 tons per hour. The bucket elevator are employed for carrying coal in vertical direction. In a coal preparation plant, the magnetic separation are used for removing iron particles. Burning of low-grade fuel can be improved by pulverizing, blending with better quality coal, and oil-assisted ignition. Which one is essential for consuming or combustion of fuel? That is oxygen, correct fuel air ratio, and proper ignition temperature. The percentage of O2 in atmospheric air is, that is 20% of volume and 23% by weight. 21% by volume and 23% by weight. The proper indication of incomplete combustion is high CO content in flue gases at exit. The smoker used in large capacity boiler, when unpulverized coal is used, that is overfeed stoker. Overfeed stoker include chain grate, spreader, and trebling grate. The equipment used for supplying coal to the boiler when unpulverized coal is being used is a stoker. The capacity of the underfeed stoker in the range of 100 to 5000 kg of coil burned per hour. The traveling grate stoker can burn coil at the rate of 150 to 200 kg per meter square. Pulverized coil is that is coil broken in fine particle. Coil broken in fine particle. Next, equipment used for pulverizing the coil in, यानी coil को pulverize करने के लिए कौन सा equipment हम use करते हैं, तो वो हम use करते हैं ball mill. Pulverized fuel is used for better burning. The advantage of using pulverized fuel including higher boiler efficiency, low air requirement and low fan power, easy and complete combustion and fast response to load change and low banking losses. The drawback of using pulverized fuel include, that is, additional investment in pulverizing plant and stack fly ash removal equipment. And second is extra power requirement for the pulverizing plant. Ash is main waste product of the steam power plant with low grade coal, maybe in tons per day. This ash can be used in building construction, can be used in brick making near the plant site, and it can be dumped in disused mines, river or sea, or in an area excavated in the wasteland as case may be. And fly ash generally result from pulverized coal boiler. Dust can be separated from gas by impingement upon small vessels, sudden velocity decrease owing to enlargement, and abrupt change of flow direction. Air pollution due to smoke around a thermal power station can be reduced by installing electrostatic precipitator. In a coal-fired thermal power station, what are the electrostatic precipitator used for? That is, to collect the dust particle from the flow ashes. Electrostatic precipitator is installed between, that is, air preheater and induced fan. And draught produced by a chimney is called, that is, natural draught. The draught produced by a steel chimney in comparison to that produced by bricks chimney for the same height is, that is, more. Steel chimney के द्वारा जो draught produce किया जाता है, वो brick chimney के द्वारा जो draught produce किया जाती है, उससे ज़्यादा होता है. Next हम देखते हैं. induced draft fan are used to induced draft fan are used to force the air inside the coil furnace. And if forced draft, the main function of chimney is to the main function of chimney is to discharge the gases high up in the atmospheric from the point of view of air pollution. The pressure at the furnace is minimum in case of balanced draft. The draft produced in locomotive boiler is by that is steam jet. The height of chimney in a steam power station is governed by that is governed by the draft to be produced. For forced draft, the blower is located. For forced draft, the blower is located near the base of the boiler. The magnitude of natural draft depend upon the magnitude of natural draft depend upon average temperature difference between the flue gases within the chimney and the outer air, the height of chimney above the furnace grate level, and weather and operating condition. The natural draft is provided by chimney and it is used in a small steam boiler. The draft produced by a chimney of a given height at a given outside temperature that is given by increase with the increase in temperature of chimney gases. The artificial draft is usually designed to produce that is designed to produce more draft, less smoke and low temperature of chimney gases. For the same draft produced by the power of the forced draft fan in comparison to that of including draft fan is that is less. Artificial draft is produced by one is induced fan and is forced fan and induced and forced fan. Next हम देखते हैं. Efficient power plant is less than that of the conventional fuel fired thermal power plant because of low temperature and pressure condition. The efficiency of nuclear power plant is less than that of the conventional fuel fired thermal power plant because of low temperature and pressure condition. The first nuclear power plant installed in India. The first nuclear power plant that is installed in India, Tarapur, Maharashtra. Western UP, Rajasthan, Punjab, Haryana, Tamil Nadu are quite suitable area for the nuclear power plant. One atomic mass unit is approximately equal to 1.66 into 10 to 10 power minus 27 per kg. One atomic mass unit is equivalent to 931.4 MeV mega electron volt. 1 kilogram of natural uranium gives energy equivalent to about that is 10,000 kilogram of coil. Generation of the 1 watt needed about 3.1 10 to the power 10 fission per second. Particles having the same atomic number but different mass number are called isotopes. Same atomic number and different mass number. In a nuclear reactor, thermal energy is obtained from fission of radioactive material. Nuclear reactor usually employed fission. In nuclear chain fission reaction, each neutron using the fission produce that is at least one new neutron. Which of the following is not a secondary nuclear fuel? That is uranium-235. Which of the following are the fertile material? That is uranium-238 and thorium-232. These are fertile material. Which of the following are fissile material? That is uranium-235, uranium-233 and plutonium-239. In the nuclear fission reaction, isotopes of uranium used is uranium-233. When a nuclear reactor is operating at a constant power, the multiplication factor is then the multiplication factor is equal to unity, is equal to unity, equal to unity. Next time देखते हैं. The function of moderator in nuclear reactor, the function of moderator in nuclear reactor is to slow down the neutrons. A moderator material should have, a moderator material should have a small atomic mass. The graphite is used in nuclear power plant as a moderator. Which of the following material cannot be used as a moderator? That is ड्यूटेरियम नॉट यूज एज ए मॉडरेटर, ग्रेफाइट भी हम यूज करते हैं, बेरिलियम हम यूज करते हैं, हैवी वाटर भी यूज करते हैं. कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग मॉडरेटर यूज्ड इन द न्यूक्लियर रिएक्टर, दैट इज ग्रेफाइट, बेरिलियम, हैवी वाटर. करेक्ट सीक्वेंस इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ दियर न्यूट्रॉन एब्जॉर्प्शन. तो सबसे ज़्यादा कम कौन करता है और सबसे ज़्यादा न्यूट्रॉन्स कौन ऑब्जर्व करता है यहाँ पर? तो सबसे ज़्यादा जो न्यूट्रॉन्स ऑब्जर्व करता है वो ग्रेफाइट करता है. तो सबसे पहले नंबर पर आएगा ग्रेफाइट, यानी ये सबसे ज़्यादा करेगा. दूसरे नंबर पर करता है वो करता है हमारा बेरिलियम, यानी इसे कम करता है ये. और तीसरे नंबर पर करता है हैवी वाटर, यानी हैवी वाटर और बेरिलियम और ग्रेफाइट, ये सीक्वेंस होगा इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर में. विच मटेरियल इज यूज इन कंट्रोलिंग चेन रिएक्शन इन न्यूक्लियर रिएक्टर, दैट इज बोरॉन. कंट्रोल रॉड यूज इन न्यूक्लियर रिएक्टर आर मेड ऑफ, कंट्रोल रॉड यूज इन न्यूक्लियर रिएक्टर आर मेड ऑफ बोरॉन. In a nuclear reactor, chain reaction is controlled by introducing, chain reaction of controlled by introducing cadmium rod. Heavy water used in nuclear reactor plant as a fuel and coolant, moderator. तो किस किस के लिए यूज करते हैं हम? एक तो कूलेंट के रूप में यूज करते हैं हैवी वाटर को, और दूसरा हम यूज करते हैं मॉडरेटर के रूप में. इन दो चीजों के लिए हम हैवी वाटर का न्यूक्लियर पावर प्लांट के अंदर यूज करते हैं. Which of the following material can be used as a coolant? That is, CO2 भी हम यूज करते हैं coolant के लिए, heavy water भी यूज कर सकते हैं, helium भी यूज कर सकते हैं. The function of reflector in a nuclear reactor is to, तो reflector का nuclear reactor में function क्या है? Bounce back most of the neutrons that escape from the fuel core. Reflector of nuclear reactor are made of, reflector of nuclear reactor are made of beryllium. Thermal shielding is provided to, thermal shielding is provided to absorb the fast neutrons, protect the operating personnel from exposure to the radiation, and prevent the reactor wall from the getting heated. The radiation shield for the nuclear power reactor for a biological safety is provided by having the reactor that is encased by thick concrete wall. In a boiler water reactor, what is the property of boiler water reactor? One is the feed water act both coolant and moderator, and second property is enrichment uranium is used as a fuel. Enrichment uranium used as a fuel. Uranium used as a fuel. And third is there is danger of radioactive contaminants of steam. There is a danger of radioactive contaminants of steam, of radioactive contamination of steam, contamination of steam. Next time देखते हैं. The power output of a nuclear power station is proportional to, the power output of a nuclear power station is proportional to the rate at which fusion reaction occur. Critical mass of a fuel is the amount required to make the multiple or multiplication factor, that is equal to unity. नेक्स्ट हम देखते हैं द ऑपरेशन ऑफ न्यूक्लियर रिएक्टर इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय कंट्रोलिंग द मल्टीप्लिकेशन फैक्टर दैट इज डिफाइंड बाय नंबर ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स ऑफ एनी वन जनरेशन डिवाइड बाय नंबर ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स ऑफ द इमीडिएटली प्रोसीडिंग जनरेशन द पावर लेवल ऑफ रिएक्टर कैन बी इंक्रीज्ड बाय द पावर रिएक्टर ऑफ पावर लेवल ऑफ रिएक्टर कैन बी इंक्रीज्ड बाय राइजिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ के अबव 1 बट लेटर ब्रिंगिंग इट बैक टू द के इक्वल टू 1 In what form of the initial energy will be released for 200 mega electron volt per fission by the neutrons in a slow thermal nuclear reactor? That is, kinetic energy of particles and electromagnetic radiation. Consider the following statement. That is, nuclear fission occur when uranium react with the neutrons. So this is also a correct statement. Nuclear fission occur when the uranium react with the neutrons. Nuclear fission accompanied by release of the neutrons and the gamma ray and about 200 mega electron volt. The energy released in the fission by uranium-235 nucleus and energy from the fission of uranium-235 nucleus is related to mainly as a kinetic energy of the neutrons and energy of gamma radiation. Which of the following statements are correct? That is, one is nuclear fission occur whenever the uranium nucleus react with the neutrons. Yeah, correct. Nuclear fission is accompanied by the release of neutrons and gamma ray. Yeah, we say about 200 mega electron volt the energy released in the fission of the uranium nucleus. Yeah, we say the energy from the fission of the uranium nucleus is reacted mainly as the kinetic energy of neutrons and energy of gamma radiation. Yeah, we say. One fission of uranium-235 release energy of that is 200 mega electron volt. Next question देखते हैं. Question है जैसे कि तारा पर atomic power station है. तारा पर atomic power station has boiling water reactor. The thermal efficiency of boiler water reactor is greater than 1. Thermal efficiency of boiler water reactor is greater than the pulverized water reactor. In a pulverized water reactor PWR, pulverized water reactor, there is light or heavy water is used as both coolant and moderator, and second is water is used at high pressure at as high as 140 kg per centimeter square, so that it is available in liquid form at about 200-280 degrees Celsius. A CANDU reactor uses natural uranium as a fuel and heavy water as a moderator and coolant. Which one of the following is employed as a moderator by the CANDU type of slow thermal nuclear reactor? That is heavy water. Which one of the following fuel is used by the slow thermal nuclear reactor for power generation? That is uranium-235. Consider the following statement regarding the nuclear power plant. First is a thermal reactor need a moderator material, and second is in a nuclear reactor, multiplication factor is kept almost equal to 1, and nuclear power plant are used as a peak load power plant. ये आप लोग गलत है. In thermal nuclear reactor, the purpose of moderator is to slow down the fast neutrons proceeded due to fission. ये भी सही है. The moderator material must have the low molecular weight. ये भी सही है यहाँ पर. Ordinary water can be used as a moderator. ये गलत है, आपका ordinary water use नहीं करते हैं. The multiplication factor is kept slightly greater than unity during its normal function. ये सही है यहाँ पर. A heavy water reactor has higher neutron flux which can produce at the given power level. Next हम देखें. एयर स्टैंडर्ड एफिशिएंसी ऑफ डीजल इंजन डिपेंड अपॉन, एयर स्टैंडर्ड एफिशिएंसी ऑफ डीजल इंजन डिपेंड ऑन कंप्रेशन रेशियो। द कंप्रेशन रेशियो इन डीजल इंजन मे बी इन रेंज ऑफ 15 to 20। द डीजल इंजन आर अवेलेबल इन साइज फ्रॉम दैट इज 75 to 750 किलोवाट। विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट इज ट्रू, दैट इज ए टू स्ट्रोक इंजन डेवलप मोर पावर फॉर द सेम स्पीड एंड पिस्टन डिस्प्लेसमेंट। द ल्यूब्रिकेशन कॉस्ट इन ए डीजल पावर प्लांट इज, ल्यूब्रिकेशन कॉस्ट इन ए डीजल पावर प्लांट इज हाई कंपेयर टू स्टीम इंजन। द इंटरनल कंबशन इंजन है, द इंटरनल कंबशन इंजन है दैट इज मच हायर थर्मल एफिशिएंसी कंपेयर टू टर्बाइन इन ए कन्वेंशनल कोल फायर्ड थर्मल स्टेशन। न्यूक्लियर पावर प्लांट टर्बाइन, न्यूक्लियर पावर प्लांट टर्बाइन यूज स्टीम एट, न्यूक्लियर पावर प्लांट टर्बाइन यूज स्टीम एट लोअर प्रेशर एंड लोअर टेम्परेचर। द इकोनॉमिक प्रॉस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द न्यूक्लियर पावर जनरेशन इन इंडिया टू ग्रेट एक्सटेंट डिपेंड ऑन द सक्सेसफुल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ दैट इज ब्रीडर रिएक्टर यूजिंग द थोरियम एज ब्लैंकेट मटेरियल एंड यूरेनियम 233 एज ए फ्यूल। सोडियम ग्रेफाइट रिएक्टर यूजेज, सोडियम ग्रेफाइट रिएक्टर यूजेज सोडियम एज ए कूलेंट एंड ग्रेफाइट एज ए मॉडरेटर। गैस कूल्ड रिएक्टर, गैस कूल्ड रिएक्टर यूजेज CO2 और हीलियम एज ए कूलेंट एंड ग्रेफाइट एज ए मॉडरेटर। एंड सेकेंड यूजेज कूलेंट एट ए प्रेशर ऑफ 14 to 28 kg per centimeter square at a temperature of 700 to 800 degree Celsius. First breed reactor are best suited for India owing to that is larger thorium deposit. The conventional ratio of breeder reactor is, the conventional ratio of breeder reactor is more than unity. Next हम देखते हैं, इन केस ऑफ डीजल इंजन द थर्मल एफिशिएंसी इन द रेंज ऑफ, इन केस ऑफ डीजल इंजन थर्मल एफिशिएंसी इन द रेंज ऑफ 30 to 40%। एन आइडियल डीजल साइकिल द वर्किंग सब्सटेंस इज, द वर्किंग सब्सटेंस इज एयर। एयर फ्यूल रेशियो रिक्वायर्ड फॉर कंबशन इन डीजल इंजन इज अराउंड दैट इज 15:1। In a diesel engine, fuel is injected at a pressure of, fuel is injected at a pressure of 90 to 130 kg per centimeter square. Maximum temperature developed in a diesel engine cylinder is in range of that is 2000 to 2500 degrees Celsius. The diesel engine, the heat loss to the cooling water is about, the heat loss to the heat loss to the cooling water is about 30%. The highest proportional of total heat supplied to a diesel engine goes to useful output. Which of the following diesel engine have the minimum air consumption per bhp, that is two stroke and air injection. Heating value of diesel oil is around, heating value of diesel oil is around 10,000 kilocalories per kg. In a four-stroke petrol engine, during the suction stroke, that is mixture of petrol and air is sucked in. In a four-stroke engine, the four operations, suction, compression, expansion and exhaust are completed in, that are completed in two revolution of crankshaft. In two-stroke engine, the four operations suction, compression, expansion, exhaust are completed in, that is one revolution of crankshaft. Most of the heat generated in IC engine goes to, most of the heat generated in IC engine goes to cooling water. Reciprocating motion of the piston is converted into rotary one. वाई कनेक्टिंग रोड. ए टू स्ट्रोक इंजन मे बी आइडेंटिफाइड बाई, ए टू स्ट्रोक इंजन मे बी आइडेंटिफाई एबसेंस ऑफ वाल्व. द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ इंजन ऑफ डिफरेंट आउटपुट स्पीड एंड साइज कैन बी कंपेयर्ड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट आर कंपेयर्ड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ स्पेसिफिक फ्यूल कंजम्पशन. द थर्मल एफिशिएंसी ऑफ डीजल इंजन इन कंपेरिजन टू दैट ऑफ पेट्रोल इंजन दैट इज हायर. थर्मल एफिशिएंसी ऑफ डीजल इंजन कंपेयर टू पेट्रोल इंजन इज हायर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन हम देखते हैं. A gas turbine work on Brayton cycle. The main drawback of gas turbine power plant are low overall efficiency and noisy operation, a limited unit and capacity, and inability of using coal or heavy residual petroleum as a fuel. The gas turbine power plant have the advantage of simplicity of design and installation, high reliability and compactness, clean exhaust of low initial cost, and second is quick starting and compatibility of putting to sheer full load in the few minutes. For larger output diesel electric power plant, the engine UID are vertical type and multi-cylinder and supercharged. Fire and flash point of the coil are important. Coil are important from the point of view of ignition and storage hazards. Which of the following will be lowest for the lubricant soil? That is pour point. The temperature at which a lubricant soil will give sufficient vapor to form a combustible mixture with air is coiled or is called as flash point. Supercharging of diesel engine supply pressurized air during the ascension and increase the power output of engine. For supercharging of diesel engine, the air is supplied through centrifugal blower. Air filter is used in diesel power plant. The temperature of cooling water leaving the diesel engine should not exceed that is 70 degrees Celsius. The high output diesel engine are started by compressed air. In a multi-cylinder engine, the firing order should be a particular sequence because it will provide the best performance of engine. नेक्स्ट हम देखते हैं. फॉर स्टार्टिंग गैस टर्बाइन इस रोटेटिंग इज यूजली मोटर्ड अप टू फॉर स्टार्टिंग गैस टर्बाइन इट्स मोटरिंग यूजली मोटर्ड अप टू दैट इज half of the turbine rated speed. In comparison to diesel engine, the gas turbine has maximum combustion pressure, that is less. For same cylindrical size and speed, which of the following engine will develop more power? That is supercharged engine. Greater part of the power developed by turbine is used in driving the compressor. It is around 65%. The work ratio of closed cycle gas turbine power plant depend upon pressure ratio, temperature ratio and specific heat ratio. The overall efficiency of gas turbine is less than that of diesel cycle. In comparison to diesel power plant, the gas turbine power plant has lower overall thermal efficiency. Mechanical efficiency of gas turbine in comparison to that of the reciprocating IC engine is higher. The thermal efficiency of gas turbine improved because of reheating of gas after partial expansion, removing the heat from the compressor air between the stage of compression, and utilizing the heat of exhaust gases to heat the compressor air before it's sent to the combustion chamber. The thermal efficiency of gas turbine cycle with ideal regeneration or regenerative heat exchanger is equal to work ratio. With the increase in pressure ratio, thermal efficiency of sample gas turbine power plant with fixed turbine inlet temperature, that is first increase and then falls. The combined cycle power plant are more appropriate for both the base and peak load. Next time देखें. To be started. Compressor has to be started before starting of gas turbine. Which of the following statement is correct? That is A. Aeroderivative turbine use clean fuel. Which of the following statement is not correct? That is the installed capacity of gas turbine plant in India exceed 20% of total installed generating capacity. That is wrong. And the efficiency of modern gas turbine power plant is more than 50%. Yes, yes. One advanced feature of the modern gas turbine power plant is higher firing temperature. Yes, yes. The gas turbine power plant has the advantage of quick starting and capacity of putting the sheer full load in few minutes. Yes, yes. The heating value of gaseous fuel is about 30 kilojoule per liter. The highest temperature ever used for gas turbine power plant is about, that is 1000 degrees Celsius. A pressure ratio in gas turbine power plant is 5 to 6. The blade of gas turbine are made of high nickel alloy. Compressor used in gas turbine, that is multi-stage axial flow compressor. A gas turbine power plant mainly use natural gas and in liquid petroleum fuel. In which of the following place 70 megawatt gas turbine power plant being operated as a base load plant? That is Namrump, Assam ke andar hai. In comparison to steam power plant, the gas power plant have low initial cost but higher operating cost. Gas turbine power plant are not widely used as a base load plant. Gas turbine is widely used in aircraft. जैसे क्वेश्चन है, कंबाइंड सर्किल पावर प्लांट आर मोर एप्रोप्रिएट फॉर कैपेसिटी फैक्टर ऑफ 20 to 50%. इन टू स्टेज गैस टर्बाइन पावर प्लांट रीहीटिंग आफ्टर फर्स्ट स्टेज इंक्रीज द वर्क रेशियो बट रिड्यूस द थर्मल एफिशिएंसी. इन ए टू स्टेज गैस टर्बाइन पावर प्लांट इंटरकूलिंग एंड रीहीटिंग इंप्रूव द वर्क रेशियो बट रिड्यूस द थर्मल एफिशिएंसी. ए जेट एयरक्राफ्ट इज पावर्ड बाय गैस टर्बाइंस. फॉर द जेट प्रोपल्शन यूनिट आइडियली द वर्क फॉर कंप्रेसर एंड दैट ऑफ द गैस टर्बाइन आर दैट इज इक्वल. इन ए क्लोज सर्किल ऑपरेशन ऑफ गैस टर्बाइन, that is load variation is affected by controlling the absolute pressure and mass flow of the circulating air, and high efficiency is maintained over the complete range of operation load and maximum unit capacity is increased. Coal and peat is not generally used in gas turbine as fuel because of the coal handling and ash handling problem. A gas turbine power plant can be used in combustion with the steam power plant. That's why using exhausted gases from the gas turbine power plant in heating of feed water coming from the steam turbine condenser and using exhaust gases from the gas turbine power plant as combustion air and steam boiler and using gas from the superheated boiler for expansion in gas turbine. In MHD generator, the conductor is made of liquid metal or gas. The nature of current developed in MHD generator. Nature of current developed in MHD generator is DC. Power output per unit volume of MHD generator is proportional to specific electrical conductivity of gas, square of the magnetic field strength, and square of fluid velocity. Sending material is injected in the working fluid in MHD generator in order to increase the conductivity of gases. A module is a series parallel arrangement of solar cell. Solar cell for power generation have the main drawback of high cost and maintenance problem. The output of solar cell in order of the output of solar cell in order of 1 watt. The voltage of solar cell is 0.5 to 1 volt. Solar cell are made of silicon. The efficiency of solar cell is about 15%. Photovoltaic solar energy conversion system makes use of solar pond. The solar or photovoltaic cell convert the solar radiation into electrical energy. Thermionic converter utilize the thermionic emission effect. The material used for electrode in thermoelectric generator are, that is, semiconductor. The concept of MHD generation depend much more on the conductivity. The advantage of MHD system are low pollution and good efficiency, absence of moving part, conversion of fuel. An MHD system for efficient operation needed, that is a magnet capable of producing high magnetic flux density, injection and recovery of seed material, and arrangement for superheating of air. In MHD generator, the ionization potential of seeding material should be lowest as possible. The exhaust from the MHD generation in a temperature of about, that is, 2200 degrees Celsius. Which of the following liquid metal is not used in MHD working fluid? MHD working fluid, that is sodium. Seeding material commonly used in MHD generator, that is potassium. Next time देखते हैं. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन है सैटेलाइट द सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी. सैटेलाइट में एनर्जी का सोर्स क्या होता है? फॉर सैटेलाइट सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी होता है सोलर सेल सैटेलाइट के लिए. सोलर सेल हैव द कन्वर्जन एफिशिएंसी ऑफ अबाउट, दैट इज 65% सोलर सेल Fuel cell has the conversion efficiency of about 65%. Fuel cell convert chemical energy into low voltage direct current electric energy. Fuel cell for power generation have the drawback of, that is, first is very high development cost and second is low service life and low voltage. The disadvantage of renewable sources of energy is are, that is, first is intermittency, lack of dependability and availability in low energy density. Biogas consists of methane and carbon dioxide and with some impurities. The main source of production of biogas are, that is, human waste, wet cow dung and wet livestock waste. The main byproduct of biogas plant is, that is, organic manure. Biogas plants are suitable for rural areas. The energy radiated by sun on a bright sunny day is about, that is, 1 kilowatt per meter square. Most of the solar radiation received on the earth's surface in within the range of, that is, 0.25 to 0.4 micron. Which of the following area is preferred for solar plant? That is, a hot and arid zones. The solar power plant, the solar heat is transferred to liquid metal and molten salt and water steam. Main application of solar energy may be considered as direct thermal application, fuel from biogas and solar electric application. Insulation. Insulation is referred to as direct radiation received at any time. Insulation. Solar thermal power generation can be had by using, that can be had by using flat plate collector, focusing or concentrating collector and solar ponds. Tidal power scheme could not be found economically justified because high cost of civil engineering work. Under favorable condition, use of wind power for first is small size power plant is possible and medium size power plant is possible. Maximum wind energy available is proportional to air density, square of rotor diameter and cube of the wind velocity. The drawback of wind power plant is, one is unreliability of and non-steady lines, steadiness, unbadly sized high structural area and quite large furnace requirement, output voltage and frequency fluctuation. Wind as a source of power that is non-steady and unreliable, does not pass the basic requirement of any energy sources, is plentiful and inexhaustible, renewable and non-polluting. A pyrometer can be used for measurement of both diesel as well as diffuse radiation, direct or diffuse radiation. A pyrometer can be used for measurement of direct and diffuse radiation. Sun tracking is required in case of cylindrical, parabolic and parabolic. Reflector mirror employed for exploiting solar energy are called the heliostat. Temperature attained by a cylindrical parabolic collector is about or in order to, that is 200 to 300 degrees Celsius and above. The flat plate collector gives a temperature of about 900 degrees Celsius with the efficiency of 30 to 35%. Flat plate collector has a plate vacant in order to absorb the maximum amount of direct radiation is placed at a proper inclination to the sun so as to absorb solar radiation is mainly used for water heating, space heating and drying. In the solar collector, the transparent cover is provided to. The transparent cover is provided to protect the collector from dust and reduce the heat losses from the collector beneath to atmospheric and transmit solar radiation only. The function of solar collector is of converting solar energy into thermal energy. Next time देखें. Tidal energy utilized. Tidal energy utilized potential energy of water. The turbine normally employed in tidal power plant is that is a reversible turbine type. A tidal power plant is installed in India near Gulf of Bombay, यानी खंबात की खाड़ी में. Geothermal energy is. Geothermal energy is a renewable energy sources, alternative energy sources, inexhaustible energy sources. Geothermal field may yield wet steam, dry steam, and hot water. Geothermal steam in hot water may contain. Geothermal steam in hot water may contain H2S, CO2, NH3, and radon gases. When the geothermal energy is available in form of saline water, power is developed using flashed steam system, binary cycle system, and total flow system. In hydrothermal source of geothermal energy, that is hot water or steam is available. A potential geothermal source, regime should have the high thermal gradient. In hydrothermal system, when steam, water, and dissolved solid are available as a source of energy, the entrained solid are removed by centrifugal separator. In comparison to conventional steam power plant, geothermal power plant have higher load factor. Presence of sand in geopressed water is likely to cause erosion problem. The presence of non-condensable gases in geopressure water cooled, that is pollution problem, second is corrosion problem, and third is flow problem. Petrothermal systems are composed of hot dry rocks with no underground water. In petrothermal system of geothermal energy having hot dry rocks but no underground water, the energy is obtained by pumping water. In geothermal power plant wastewater is discharged back to earth. Next time dekhen. The steam power plant is being supplied with a coil having the much more ash content than that of which is it was designed. Which of the following unit need the major modification? That is ash handling unit. In a steam power plant, which of the following component need maximum maintenance attention? That is boiler. Which of the following plant has the maximum capital cost? That is nuclear plant. Which of the following generating plant has the minimum operating cost? That is hydroelectric plant. Which of the following plant which take least time in starting from the cold condition to full load condition? that is hydroelectric plant. Which power plant cannot have a single unit of 100 megawatt capacity? That is diesel engine power plant. Which of the following power plant is free from environment problem? That is hydroelectric power plant. Which of the following power plant normally operated at high speed? That is steam turbine. A generating station which has high investment cost and low operating cost is usually operated at base load station. The power station that does not require any moving part, that power plant or power station is called a thermionic converter. For underwater movement of submarine, the power is provided by batteries. Which of the following power plant can generate power at unpredictable or uncontrollable time? That is wind power plant, solar power plant and diesel power plant. Direct conversion of heat energy into electrical energy is possible through, that is, first is MHD generator and second is thermionic converter. In a fuel cell, electrical energy is produced by reaction of hydrogen with oxygen. In a fuel cell, cathode is of hydrogen. Next, the generating station suitable for operate as peak load plant. तो पीक लोड प्लांट के लिए हम कौन सा जनरेटिंग स्टेशन यहाँ पर यूज करते हैं? तो पीक लोड प्लांट के लिए हम जो जनरेशन यूज करते हैं वो करते हैं पंप्ड स्टोरेज पावर स्टेशन. पीक लोड प्लांट के लिए यूज किया जाता है इसका पंप्ड स्टोरेज पावर स्टेशन. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग पावर स्टेशन इज मेनली यूज टू कवर द पीक लोड ऑन द सिस्टम? दैट इज पंप्ड स्टोरेज पावर प्लांट. In an interconnected power system, the most suitable power plant to meet the peak load condition is, that is, pumped storage. The essential requirement for power plant to be operated as peak load plant are, that is, capability of quick start and synchronizing and taking of the system cost load, quick response to load variation and low capital cost. Efficiency is of little importance in case of peak load plant. The modern trends in electric power generation is to have the large size thermal power plant located near coal field. Interconnected systems have the advantage of reduce the reserve plant capacity, capital cost per kilowatt and economic in operation. Improved load factor, diversity factor and operational efficiency and increased reliability of supply. An interconnected system has the following power plant, that is, first is diesel and second is gas turbine and third is pump storage plant that are supplying peak load. Which two of the power plant mentioned in here are used exclusively for supplying base load? तो base load के लिए कौन-कौन से plant यहाँ पर use किए जाते हैं? Base load के लिए यहाँ पर जो use किए जाएंगे base load के लिए वो है हमारा एक तो nuclear power plant है, ये base load के लिए use किया जाता है और दूसरा हमारा run of river plant है, ये base load के लिए use किया जाता है. In moderate size steam power station, electrical power is generated at 11 kV. If two synchronous generators are connected, loss of synchronism will result in stalling of generator. Next हम देखते हैं. Shunt capacitor in a substation. Deliver lagging VAR. The principle of increment cost is employed for deciding the load allocation between unit and operation. For economy measure the generator at a power plant operate at equal incremental cost. Two generating plant feed a load center through a transmission network for maximum economy. That is, the incremental cost of power supplied at the load center should be same for both the plant. In a optimum generator scheduling different power plant, the minimum fuel cost is obtained when the increment fuel cost of each plant multiplied by its plenty factor is the same. In a generating station is suited very close to load center, the plenty factor for this unit is almost unity. The cost function of the 50 megawatt generator is given by P1 is the generating loading. When 100% loading is applied, the incremental fuel cost will be. So incremental fuel cost क्या आ जाएगी यहाँ पर जब calculate करेंगे, तो ये आएगी 55 per megawatt. तो ये न्यूमेरिकल है, हम बाद में इसको सॉल्व कर लेंगे, ये भी न्यूमेरिकल बाद में सॉल्व कर लेंगे हम, और ये भी यहाँ पर न्यूमेरिकल है, इसको हम बाद में सॉल्व करेंगे. जैसे कि इसका जो आंसर आएगा वो आएगा जनरेटर ए के लिए यहाँ पर आएगा 450 मेगावाट, और जनरेटर बी के लिए जो आएगा वो आएगा हमारा 250 मेगावाट. नेक्स्ट देखते हैं. ए पावर सिस्टम नीड इंजेक्शन ऑफ बीएआर एट दैट इज पीक लोड एंड ऑफ पीक लोड. बोथ पीक लोड एंड ऑफ पीक लोड टू मीट द रिएक्टिव पावर रिक्वायरमेंट एट लोड सेंटर यूजुअली शंट कैपेसिटर आर यूज्ड. फॉर स्टेबल ऑपरेशन ऑफ इंटरकनेक्टेड सिस्टम द पैसिव एलिमेंट दैट कैन बी यूज्ड एज द इंटरकनेक्टिंग एलिमेंट इज दैट इज रिएक्टर. नेक्स्ट हम देखें, जनरेटर आर फीडिंग ए लोड ऑफ 100 मेगावाट. The details of generator are also given, and generator 1, generator 2, generator 3, efficiency also given, and regulation per MVA also given. If the event is increased load power demand, which of the following will happen? So, क्या होगा अगर load demand increase होगी यहाँ पर? तो सबसे पहले होगा यहाँ पर generator 1 है, वो यहाँ पर efficiency की ज़्यादा है, तो generator 1 will share more power compared to generator 2, because the efficiency of generator 1 is less than the generator efficiency of generator second. So regulation on 100 MVA is less in generator 1, so generator 1 will share more power compared to generator 2. Next term dekhen, three identical generator supply power is system having the lossless transmission line. Generator 1 is equipped with the speed governed by its maintained speed constant at the rated value. While generator 2 and 3 have the governor with a drop of 5% 4% respectively. For given increase in system load in the steady state, that is given by generator 1 will alone take the entire increased load and the output of generator 2 and 3 will remain unchanged. ये numerical है, ये हम बाद में देखेंगे. Unit of regulation of speed govern is hertz per megawatt. A large synchronous generator is feeding power into an infinite bus at a slightly lagging power factor. If a load loss of the field occur and system can supply sufficient reactive power without a large terminal voltage drop, the unit will runs as a induction generator and it should be tripped after a time delay. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन हम देखते हैं. ये न्यूमेरिकल है, ये हम बाद में देखेंगे। तो ये भी यहाँ पर न्यूमेरिकल है, ये भी हम बाद में देखेंगे, ये भी यहाँ पर न्यूमेरिकल है, ये हम बाद में देखेंगे, ये न्यूमेरिकल है, ये हम बाद में देखेंगे, ये न्यूमेरिकल है, ये हम बाद में देखेंगे। और फिर नेक्स्ट देखते हैं हम। अब जैसे कि ये न्यूमेरिकल है, ये भी हम बाद में देखेंगे, ये भी यहाँ पर एक न्यूमेरिकल है, ये हम बाद में देखेंगे। ये भी न्यूमेरिकल है, ये हम बाद में देखेंगे। ये हम देखते हैं बाद में। कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट रिगार्डिंग लोड फ्रीक्वेंसी कंट्रोल। तो लोड फ्रीक्वेंसी कंट्रोल से रिलेटेड स्टेटमेंट है, जैसे कि इंटीग्रल कंट्रोल लिमिट द स्टैटिक फ्रीक्वेंसी ड्रॉप, ये सही है यहाँ पर। और दूसरा है द टाई लाइन लोड बायस कंट्रोल, द कंट्रोल सिग्नल फॉर ईच एरिया इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू चेंज इन फ्रीक्वेंसी एज वेल एज चेंज इन टाई लाइन पावर। कंसिडर द पावर सिस्टम विद टू पावर प्लांट, वन इज एस वन एस टू, सोच टाई लाइन एज इज शोन इन फिगर। व्हेन द लोड फ्रीक्वेंसी कंट्रोल ऑफ द सिस्टम इज कंसिडर्ड, द फ्लैट टाई लाइन कंट्रोल सिस्टम इज प्रीफर्ड ओवर द फ्लैट फ्रीक्वेंसी रेगुलेशन सिस्टम, बिकॉज ऑफ द लोड चेंज इन पर्टिकुलर एरिया इज टेकन केयर ऑफ बाई द जनरेटर इन एरिया ऑफ रिजल्टिंग इन टाई लाइन लोडिंग टू रिमेन द कॉन्स्टेंट। ये न्यूमेरिकल है, ये हम बाद में देखेंगे, ये भी न्यूमेरिकल है, ये हम बाद में देखेंगे, ये न्यूमेरिकल है हमारा, ये भी हम बाद में देखेंगे। इसका जो आंसर आएगा वो क्या आएगा, ये आएगा हमारा, यानी कि PG1 की जो वैल्यू है ये वाली आएगी 20, और PG2 की जो वैल्यू है वो आएगी 22, ये 40 MW। बाद में देखेंगे। नेक्स्ट हम देखते हैं, लोड फ्रीक्वेंसी कंट्रोल आर कैरिड आउट विथ, लोड फ्रीक्वेंसी कंट्रोल आर कैरिड आउट विथ, दैट इज PID कंट्रोलर। लोड फ्रीक्वेंसी कंट्रोल यूजेज, लोड फ्रीक्वेंसी कंट्रोल यूजेज बोथ प्रोपोर्शनल एंड इंटीग्रल कंट्रोलर। द मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ लोड फ्रीक्वेंसी कंट्रोलर इज अप्लाई कंट्रोल ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड एट द सेम टाइम ऑफ रियल पावर एक्सचेंज विथ आउट गोइंग लाइन। AGC वोल्टेज एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय, AGC वोल्टेज एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी कंट्रोल्ड बाय टर्बाइन स्पीड कंट्रोल एंड एग्जिस्ट एक्साइटेशन कंट्रोल रेस्पेक्टिवली। द मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ लोड फ्रीक्वेंसी कंट्रोल इन ए पावर सिस्टम आर, दैट इज फर्स्ट इज टू ब्रिंग द स्टेडी स्टेट एरर टू जीरो आफ्टर लोड चेंज, एंड सेकेंड इज टू मेंटेन द नेट टाई लाइन फ्लो। द टर्म ऑफ पावर जनरेशन एंड बी मिनिमम कोफिशिएंट द ट्रांसमिशन लॉस फॉर ए टू पावर प्लांट, द नोटेशन हैविंग देयर यूजुअल मीनिंग, दैट इज P1 square V11 to P1 P2 V12 and P2 square V22. The penalty factor of plant is unity. Its incremental transmission loss is incremental transmission cost is 0.00. The unit of transmission loss coefficient is unit of transmission loss coefficient, that is megawatt inverse. And they consider the power system with three identical generators. The transmission losses are negligible. One generator has the speed governed by the maintenance speed constant at the rated value, while the other generator G1, G2 and G3 have the governed with the drop of 5%. If the load in system is increased, then the steady state generator G1 allows increase, while the generator G2 and G3 is unchanged. Next question dekhte hain. ये क्वेश्चन है, एन आइसोलेटेड 50 हर्ट्ज सिंक्रोनस जनरेटर इज रेटेड एट 15 मेगावाट. दिस इज आल्सो मैक्सिमम कंटीन्यूअस पावर लिमिट ऑफ इट्स प्राइम मूवर. इट इज इक्विप्ड विद द स्पीड गवर्नर विद 5% ड्रॉप. इनिशियली द जनरेटर इज फीडिंग थ्री लोड 4 मेगावाट ईच ऑफ 50 हर्ट्ज. वन ऑफ दीज लोड इज प्रोग्राम्ड टू ट्रिप द परमानेंटली इफ द फ्रीक्वेंसी फॉल्स बिलो 48 मेगाहर्ट्ज. If the additional load of 3.5 megawatt is connected, then the frequency will settle down. The frequency will settle down 49.417. ये एक numerical है. Power system has two synchronous generator. The governor time, turbine gustis corresponding to generator are given, and where F denote the system frequency in hertz and FP1 and P2 respectively the power output in megawatt, turbine 1 and 2. Assuming generator and transmission network to lossless, the system frequency for load, system frequency for total load of 400 megawatt is, that is calculated 48.0 hertz. ये भी numerical है, ये हम बाद में करेंगे. 45.33 hertz जाएगा. ये यहाँ पर हम देखते हैं कि for a synchronous generator connected to an infinite bus through a transmission line, how are the change of voltage and the change of frequency related to the active power and reactive power? That is given by delta voltage proportional to Q and delta F is to P. ये है question. फिर हम देखते हैं ये question है, ये question है. What is the correct expression for area control error for the interconnected two area power system? If del Pi is the incremental tie line power deviation and del F is the frequency deviation and V is the frequency wise coefficient, then AC is the del P1 plus V del F. The voltage of the bus can be controlled by controlling the reactive power of bus. Permissible variation of frequency in power system, that is allowed only the 3% of frequency variation. The annual cost of generating station can be expressed in form of A plus B into K dot kilowatt. And ये fixed cost है, variable cost है, ये running cost है. Where A, B, C are constant and kilowatt and kilowatt hour represent the capacity of station and energy generated per year respectively. The choice between the base load station and the peak load station basically depend on the fact that the factor B should be less for the peak load station and factor C should be less for the base load station. A pilot exciter is provided on the synchronous generator to excite the main exciter. The generator for a power plant to supply the excessive peak load are usually designed for maximum efficiency to occur at 50 to 75% of full load. Generator for base load plant are usually designed for maximum efficiency around, that is maximum efficiency around, that is full load. When the load shedding is restored, it can be concluded that load on the system is more than the installed capacity. Load shedding is done for load shedding is done for reducing peak load demand on the system. During load shedding, the system load are switched off. Any load frequency control system with the free governor action, the increase in load demand and under steady condition is met. Under steady condition met only by increasing generation due to the opening of steam valve. Load frequency control is achieved by properly matching the individual machine. That is turbine input. When there is a change in the load in a power station having the having a number of generator unit operating in parallel, the system frequency is controlled by. The system frequency is controlled by adjusting the steam input to the unit. Installment towards depreciation increase with increase in interest rates in case of sink fund depreciation. Annual depreciation of plant is proportional to the earning capacity of plant in case of reducing balance depreciation. Annual estimation depreciation charge for plant are heavy during yearly year in case of diminishing value method. In a power plant, insurance cover is provided for equipment and skilled and unskilled worker. A company can raise fund through share, fixed deposit and bonds. All of the following are the source of borrowing money except that is share. Which of the following are not repayable after a stipulated period? That is shares. During summer season, load on the system increase. This is due to increased use of fan and air cooler and air conditioner. The connected load of domestic consumer medium income group is usually about that is 2 to 5 kilowatt. Power demand can be estimated approximately by statistical method. The load curve is a plot of load versus time. The chronological load curve indicates the variation in demand from instant to instant during 24 hour. Next हम देखते हैं. Time method and some charger. And a straight line method, the annual depreciation charge are calculated by. The capital cost minus the salvage value divided by number of year of life. In straight line method, annual depreciation charge is given by that formula. Ideally, depreciation value of plant plus the accumulation in depreciation fund should be equal to original investment value. The equipment purchased for 25 lakh 3 years before has now market value of 32 lakh. It shows that it shows that the value has appreciated with time. Salvage value of plant is maybe always zero, is always positive or is always negative. तो कुछ भी हो सकता है salvage value plant की. यानी या तो पॉजिटिव होगी या नेगेटिव होगी या जीरो होगी. द एनुअल डिप्रिसिएशन रिजर्व डिपेंड ऑन एनुअल डिप्रिसिएशन रिजर्व डिपेंड अपॉन दैट इज डिपेंड अपॉन कैपिटल कॉस्ट ओनली सेल्वेज वैल्यू ओनली ऑन द मेथड ऑफ कैलकुलेशन डिप्रिसिएशन रिजर्व. द लॉन्ग टर्म लोड फोरकास्ट इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द लॉन्ग टर्म लोड फोरकास्ट इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर that is planning the addition in generation capacity. The capital cost of power plant depend on the capital cost of power plant depend upon total installed capacity and number of unit as well. The interest on capital cost is included in the interest on capital cost is included in annual fixed cost. For a nuclear power plant the useful life is expected to about useful life is expected to about 30 years. In a power plant, which of the following item falls in the category of semi-fixed charge? That is, annual interest and depreciation on capital cost, all type of taxes and insurance charges, and salaries of management and clerical staff. In a power plant, which of the following item does not fall in the category of operating cost? That is, salaries of management and clerical staff. In a steam power station, which of the following is not a fixed cost? That is, fuel and lubricating oil cost. For a power plant, the expenditure on which of the following item is expected to be almost negligible, that is publicity. Annual operating cost of a generating plant consists of fixed charge, semi-fixed charge, and operating or running charge. Next हम देखते हैं. Maximum demand on power system is that is given by the greatest of all short time interval average demand during the period. The power system experienced a peak demand from 6 pm to 10 pm. Connected load means the installed electrical load in the premises of consumers. The maximum demand of a power system is greatest average load in a specific time. Demand factor is defined as the ratio of maximum demand to connected load. और इसकी शॉर्टकट क्या हो सकती है? DMC हो सकती है. यानी demand factor equal to maximum demand बटे connected load. तो ये हो गया DMC. Demand factor on a power system is, तो demand factor है power system में greater than होगा तो maximum demand बटे connected load. Maximum जो demand है वो हमेशा connected load से क्या हो सकती है, less than होगी या greater than होगी? ये हमेशा less than होती है, ग्रेटर देन होती है. मैक्सिमम डिमांड है कनेक्टेड लोड से ग्रेटर देन होती है, तो ये हमेशा ग्रेटर देन यूनिटी होगा. जो डिमांड फैक्टर है पावर सिस्टम का वो हमेशा ग्रेटर देन यूनिटी होगा, क्योंकि मैक्सिमम डिमांड है हमारी वो कभी कभी बढ़ती है, तो मैक्सिमम हो सकती है यानी कनेक्टेड लोड से मैक्सिमम हो सकती है. तो ये मैक्सिमम डिमांड है, जैसे कि हमारे पास में घर के अंदर जो इक्विपमेंट कनेक्टेड हैं वो है हमारे पास में 100 100 वाट के 3 बल्ब कनेक्टेड है, यानी 300 वाट के बल्ब लगा हुआ है। तो 300 वाट से अगर ज्यादा ये हो जाएगी मैक्सिमम डिमांड, यानी 400 वाट हो जाती है, तो ये बल्ब जल जाएंगे। इसलिए हमेशा ये कम रहेगी, हमेशा से कम रहने की वजह से हमारे पास में ये आंसर नहीं होगा, ये होगा ऑलवेज लेस देन यूनिटी। डिमांड फैक्टर ऑफ पावर फैक्टर है, तो ये हमेशा 299 हो सकती है मैक्सिमम, इससे ज्यादा नहीं हो सकती। तो इस वजह से डिमांड फैक्टर है पावर सिस्टम का, वो ऑलवेज लेसर देन यूनिटी होगा। द लोड फैक्टर इज इक्वल टू, और लोड फैक्टर क्या होता है? लोड फैक्टर इक्वल टू होता है हमारा एवरेज लोड डिवाइडेड बाय पीक लोड। तो लोड फैक्टर के लिए शॉर्टकट क्या बन जाएगी? लेफ बन जाएगी, यानी लोड फैक्टर इक्वल टू एवरेज लोड डिवाइड बाय पीक लोड लैब। तो लैब से हम देख सकते हैं लोड फैक्टर इक्वल टू एवरेज लोड डिवाइड बाय पीक लोड। पावर स्टेशन प्लांट लोड फैक्टर इज डिफाइंड एज द रेशियो ऑफ, ए पावर स्टेशन प्लांट लोड फैक्टर इज डिफाइंड एज द रेशियो ऑफ, डिफाइंड एज द रेशियो ऑफ एवरेज लोड टू पीक लोड। लोड फैक्टर ऑफ पावर प्लांट है, अब लोड फैक्टर पावर प्लांट का क्या होगा, यानी एवरेज लोड और पीक लोड। अब पीक लोड मैक्सिमम हो सकता है या एवरेज लोड मैक्सिमम हो सकता है, तो यहाँ पर हमेशा ये भी हम देखें कि ये लेस देन होगा, क्योंकि जो एवरेज लोड है हमारा, एवरेज लोड हमेशा कम होगा, पीक लोड हमेशा ज्यादा होगा। तो इस वजह से ये ऑलवेज लेस देन यूनिटी होगा। लोड फैक्टर फॉर डोमेस्टिक लोड में भी टेकन है, डोमेस्टिक लोड के लिए लोड फैक्टर कितना लिया जाएगा? डोमेस्टिक लोड फैक्टर है डोमेस्टिक लोड के लिए, वो लिया जाता है 10 to 15%। लोड फैक्टर फॉर हैवी इंडस्ट्री के लिए कितना लिया जाता है? हैवी इंडस्ट्री के लिए लिया जाता है ये 70 से 80%। इंडस्ट्रियल कंज्यूमर है दी लोड पैटर्न ऑफ 2000 किलोवाट 0.8 लैगिंग फॉर दी 12 आवर एंड 1000 किलोवाट यूनिटी पावर फैक्टर फॉर 12 आवर दी लोड फैक्टर इज। तो लोड फैक्टर यहाँ पर हम कैलकुलेट करेंगे तो ये कितना आएगा? 0.75 आ जाएगा। लोड फैक्टर क्या होता है? लोड फैक्टर हम निकालते हैं LAP से, यानी एवरेज डिमांड बाय पीक डिमांड पीक लोड। तो एवरेज लोड क्या है हमारा? ये है 12 आवर के लिए, और पीक लोड क्या है? ये है हमारा 1000। तो ये वैल्यू आ जाएगी, यानी 1000 × 1 × 12 आ जाएगा यहाँ पर, यहाँ पर आ जाएगा नीचे 2000 × 0.8, तो ये नीचे आएगा ये ऊपर आएगा, यानी कि 2000 × 0.8 डिवाइड बाई 1000। तो जैसे इसको कैलकुलेट करेंगे 1000 डिवाइड बाई, और ये हो जाएगा 1600, यानी हो जाएगा 1600 डिवाइड बाई 1000। तो ये इससे कट जाएगा, इससे ये कट जाएगा, तो हम 10 में हम 16 का भाग देंगे तो क्या आएगा? 0.75 आएगा। तो ये हमारा हो जाएगा जो पावर है, ये यूनिटी पावर फैक्टर पर है, यूनिटी पावर फैक्टर पर होगा हमारा एवरेज, और ये होगा हमारा पीक, ये होगा हमारा पीक, और ये होगा हमारा एवरेज यूनिटी पावर फैक्टर। तो ये पीक होगा और ये हमारा एवरेज होगा। मैक्सिमम डिमांड ऑन ए स्टीम पावर स्टेशन इज 480 मेगावाट। इफ द एनुअल लोड फैक्टर इज 40%, देन टोटल एनर्जी जनरेटेड एनुअली, तो वो हम निकाल लेंगे, तो ये आएगी हमारी 6168192×10⁵ kWh। नेक्स्ट हम देखते हैं कैपेसिटी फैक्टर विल बी वेरी लो व्हेन द पावर प्लांट इज, कैपेसिटी फैक्टर विल बी वेरी लो व्हेन पावर प्लांट इज ऑपरेटेड इन इमरजेंसी ओनली। कैपेसिटी फैक्टर विल बी वेरी लो व्हेन पावर प्लांट इज ऑपरेटेड इन इमरजेंसी ओनली। ए थर्मल जनरेटिंग स्टेशन हैज द इंस्टॉल कैपेसिटी, थर्मल जनरेटिंग स्टेशन हैज द इंस्टॉल कैपेसिटी ऑफ 15 मेगावाट and supplies a daily load of 10 megawatt for 12 hour and 5 megawatt for remaining 12 hour. The plant capacity factor for this station is that is given by तो ये हम कैलकुलेट करेंगे तो ये आएगा 0.5. The power generating station has the maximum demand of 1000 megawatt. Annual load factor 75% and plant capacity factor 60% है. Reserve capacity इसकी कैलकुलेट करेंगे तो ये आएगी हमारी 250 megawatt. Generating station has the 500 megawatt maximum demand and annual load factor 5%. Capacity factor है 40% है. Reserve capacity हम plant की कैलकुलेट करेंगे तो ये आएगी हमारी 125 megawatt. A generating station has the maximum demand of 30 megawatt and a load factor of 60% and a plant capacity factor of 50%. Then the reserve capacity of plant is. So reserve capacity plant की यहाँ पर आ जाएगी 6 megawatt. तो ये लगा है load duration curve for the power station as shown in the given figure. The reserve capacity of plant at 70%. तो 70% पर reserve capacity क्या होगी? ये होगी हमारी 10 megawatt. 70% पर. If the rated plant capacity, the maximum load of the power station are equal, then we can say utilization factor is unity and load factor and capacity factor are equal. Spanning reserve is the reserve generating capacity which is connected to the bus and is ready to take load. The power which must be available ever under emergency condition is known as. That power is known as firm reserve. In a power plant, the reserve generating capacity which is operation but not in service is called. That is called hot reserve. In a power plant, a reverse generating capacity which is in operation condition and available for service but not in operation is called. That is called a reserve. Next term देखें. Utilization factor is defined as the ratio of. Maximum demand on power station to the rated capacity of power plant. Which of the following statement is correct? That is, capacity factor equal to load factor and utilization factor. Plant capacity factor is actual energy produced divided by maximum possible energy that could have been produced based on initial cost. Installed cost. The knowledge of diversity factor help in computing. The plant capacity. Diversity factor has direct effect on fixed cost per unit generated. Diversity factor into maximum demand. That is sum of the consumer maximum demand. Diversity factor in a power system is. Diversity factor in a power system is always more than unity. The daily energy produced in a thermal power station is 720 megawatt at a load factor of 0.6. What is the maximum demand of the station? That is 50 megawatt. Diversity factor is the ratio of sum of the maximum demand of consumer system maximum demand. The load curve of the system is shown in the figure. The load factor of the system is 60.13%. Next term, which of the following relation called goods? So good मतलब कि सही कौन सा है इनमें? कौन सा relation यहाँ पर सही है? तो पहला तो है मैक्सिमम डिमांड है वो कनेक्टेड लोड इनटू लोड फैक्टर डिमांड फैक्टर होता है. मैक्सिमम डिमांड इक्वल टू कनेक्टेड लोड इनटू डिमांड फैक्टर, यानी डिमांड फैक्टर आपको निकालना है तो वो डीएमसी फार्मूला हो जाएगा. यानी डिमांड फैक्टर इक्वल टू मैक्सिमम डिमांड बटे कनेक्टेड लोड. इसी तरीके से लोड फैक्टर निकालना है तो लोड फैक्टर हो जाता है हमारा लैम्प हो जाएगा, जैसे एक लैम्प होता है एक लैम्प होता है, लोड फैक्टर इक्वल टू लैम्प एल ए एम, लोड फैक्टर इक्वल टू एवरेज लोड डिवाइड बाई मैक्सिमम लोड। और कैपेसिटी फैक्टर है ये यहाँ से निकाल सकते हैं, जैसे कि लैम्प है, इसी तरीके से यहाँ पर क्या हो सकता है, ये भी हो सकता है यहाँ पर एल सी यू, यानी कि एल सी यू मतलब कि एक लव है, इसमें से ये हटा दीजिए, एल सी यू हो जाएगा, तो ये हो जाएगा कैपेसिटी फैक्टर डिवाइड बाई यूटिलाइजेशन फैक्टर, ये हो जाएगा हमारा लोड फैक्टर का, ये का फार्मूला। द लार्ज डाइवर्सिटी फैक्टर ऑफ ए लोड इन ए पावर सिस्टम, लार्ज डाइवर्सिटी फैक्टर ऑफ ए लोड इन ए पावर सिस्टम दैट इज गिवन बाई रिड्यूस दी इंस्टॉलेशन कॉस्ट एज द लोड फैक्टर ऑफ जनरेटिंग प्लांट इंक्रीज द जनरेशन कॉस्ट पर के डब्ल्यू एच जनरेटेड दैट इज डिक्रीज। इन ऑर्डर टू हैव लोअर कॉस्ट ऑफ पावर जनरेशन द लोड फैक्टर एंड डाइवर्सिटी फैक्टर शुड बी हाई। द इकोनॉमिक्स ऑफ द पावर प्लांट ग्रेटली इन्फ्लुएंस बाई फर्स्ट इज लोड फैक्टर, सेकेंड इज यूटिलाइजेशन फैक्टर, थर्ड इज यूनिटी कैपेसिटी यूनिट कैपेसिटी एंड थर्ड इज फोर्थ इज टाइप ऑफ लोड। फ्लैट रेट टैरिफ कैन बी चार्ज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ यूनिट कंज्यूम्ड, डोमेस्टिक कंज्यूमर आर यूजुअली चार्ज, डोमेस्टिक कंज्यूमर आर यूजुअली चार्ज ब्लॉक रेट टैरिफ। इफ द टैरिफ ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी चार्ज प्रोवाइडेड इंसेंटिव बाई वे ऑफ रिड्यूस चार्ज फॉर हायर कंजम्पशन दिस देन इट मे बी कंक्लूडेड दैट पावर प्लांट हैज सफिशियंट रिजर्व कैपेसिटी। टू पार्ट टैरिफ इज चार्ज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कनेक्टेड लोड एंड यूनिट कंज्यूम। ब्लॉक रोटर टैरिफ वेयर एनर्जी चार्ज डिक्रीज विथ इंक्रीज इन एनर्जी कंजम्पशन दैट इज एनकरेज द कंज्यूमर फॉर मोर कंजम्पशन। द पेनल्टी फॉर लो पावर फैक्टर इज इम्पोज ऑन इंडस्ट्रियल कंज्यूमर। डॉहर्टी रेट टैरिफ इज अप्लाइड टू बल्क सप्लाई। मैक्सिमम डिमांड टैरिफ इज जनरली नॉट एप्लीकेबल टू डोमेस्टिक कंज्यूमर आउंग टू दियर लो मैक्सिमम डिमांड, लो मैक्सिमम डिमांड। नेक्स्ट हम देखते हैं द मोस्ट इकोनॉमिकल लिमिट ऑफ पावर फैक्टर, द मोस्ट इकोनॉमिकल लिमिट ऑफ पावर फैक्टर करेक्टिंग इज गवर्न्ड बाई रिलेटिव कॉस्ट ऑफ सप्लाई एंड पावर फैक्टर करेक्शन इक्विपमेंट। रिलेटिव कॉस्ट ऑफ सप्लाई एंड पावर फैक्टर करेक्शन इक्विपमेंट एंड इंडस्ट्रियल इंस्टॉलेशन हैज द पावर फैक्टर ऑफ 0.8 लैगिंग, इट वुड बी इकोनॉमिकल टू इम्प्रूव द पावर फैक्टर अबाउट 0.95 लैगिंग। द मोस्ट सुटेबल लोकेशन ऑफ पावर फैक्टर इम्प्रूवमेंट डिवाइस इज दैट इज फर्स्ट इज नियर द इलेक्ट्रिकल अप्लायंस विच इज रेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर पुअर पावर फैक्टर एंड सेकेंड इज एट द रिसीविंग एंड इन केस ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन लाइन। एडवांटेज ऑफ इम्प्रूव्ड पावर फैक्टर आर बेटर यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ किलोवाट कैपेसिटी ऑफ प्राइम मूवर ट्रांसफॉर्मर एंड स्विच गियर एंड द लाइंस। फॉर पावर फैक्टर इम्प्रूवमेंट सिंक्रोनस कंडेंसर हैव द ड्रॉबैक ऑफ कंपेरेटिवली हायर मेंटेनेंस एंड ऑपरेटिंग कॉस्ट, रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ ऑक्यूलर इक्विपमेंट फॉर द स्टार्टिंग एंड पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ फॉलिंग आउट ऑफ द सिंक्रोनिज्म फ्यूजिंग इन इंटरप्शन ऑफ सप्लाई। फॉर पावर फैक्टर इम्प्रूवमेंट स्टेटिक कैपेसिटर हैव द ड्रॉबैक ऑफ Static capacitor have the drawback of short service life, getting damaged by high voltage and not repairable. For power factor improvement, static capacitor have the advantage of small losses, easy installation, low initial cost and little maintenance. The static capacitor are rated in term of kVAr. Power factor can be improved by using synchronous condenser, phase advancer and static capacitor. For consumer, the most economical power factor is usually that is usually 0.85 and 0.95 lagging. The power factor of an individual plant is uneconomical for the both owner of the plant and electric power utility. The low power factor has the drawback of increased transmission and distribution losses, poor voltage regulation, high cost of equipment for the given load. The primary reason for low power factor is owing to installation of induction motor. तो ये सारे क्वेश्चन हैं जो हमने किए हैं यहाँ पर, इन सबकी जो पीडीएफ है वो वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन में मिल जाएगी. 500 से ऊपर ये क्वेश्चन है.